House lawmakers have approved an amendment ending all support for the Saudi-led bombing campaign in Yemen. Brigida Santos joins me now to talk about that. Brigida, first of all, what can you tell me about the amendment? What are the details here?
The amendment to the 2022 National Defense Authorization Act was introduced by Senator Bernie Sanders and Congressman Ro Khanna, who says, quote, our amendment would end all U.S. logistical support and transfer of spare parts for Saudi warplanes that are bombing Yemen, bombing schools, killing children, and bombing civilians in the largest humanitarian crisis around the world. Khanna says they introduced this amendment to finally end U.S. complicity in the Saudi-led war on Houthi rebels in Yemen, which the U.S. has supported since 2015. While the bill passed in the House of Representatives, it now goes to the Senate for upper chamber NDAA conference negotiations.
You know, the difficulty that the Saudis have had is that it's like they could lose their whole control over Saudi Arabia, the royal family can, unless they can control the radicals. You know, the radicals are kind of in control right now in Yemen, and they're afraid that's going to bleed over to Saudi Arabia. I mean, the connection is all about the royal family. There's no reason for these bombings. There's absolutely no reason for these bombings. They're killing civilians by the hundreds and thousands. The House also passed another amendment to the defense bill that undermines the amendment by... It's introduced by Senator Sanders and Congressman Khanna. Tell me about that, if you would.
Yeah, that's right. Democratic lawmakers also passed an amendment to the National Defense Authorization Act, introduced by House Foreign Affairs Committee Chair Gregory Meeks. Now, that amendment prohibits the maintenance of American-made warplanes used by Saudi military units that the president personally finds responsible for offensive airstrikes that result in civilian casualties. Now, that's great. However, there's one major caveat, an exception that allows the U.S. to continue providing maintenance to warplanes defending Saudi territory from Houthi attacks. Now, this amendment could essentially be used as a loophole by the Biden administration to continue offensive operations in Yemen, permitting business as usual and, of course, undermining the Bernie Sanders-Ro Khanna bill.
What's the likelihood of these amendments passing, Brigida, as you see it right now? I hear this. There's just so much division right now within the Democratic Party. It's just the division's crazy. What do you think about this actually passing?
Well, this is the first time since the Saudi-led coalition launched its military intervention in Yemen that the Democrats have had control over the White House and the upper and lower chamber of Congress. However, both parties have consistently been united on war. So we're going to have to wait and see whether Congress thinks taxpayers should stop bankrolling maintenance and spare parts for Saudi warplanes to continue bombing civilians, or if it chooses to keep fueling the world's largest humanitarian crisis. Now, in the end, it's entirely possible that the Sanders-Khanna amendment is scrapped and the watered-down amendment with all those loopholes proposed by Congressman Meeks makes that final annual defense authorization bill. We'll have to wait and see.
Yeah, the loopholes are for the weapons industry. The weapons industry is making so much money. It's always just follow the money. Follow the money on the weapons, follow the money on the oil. That's what it's about. And in Congress right now, you have so many Democrats that are just so... So just an extension of Wall Street. So I don't have a lot of hope for this, to tell you the truth. Thank you for joining me, okay?
Thanks, Mike.